Good evening, guys. This is Darren from Jace Media. And in the chair tonight, we have vocal powerhouse in the form of Scarlett Riot and the young lady herself. Scarlett, how are you?
Hi, I'm good, thank you. How are you doing?
I'm great, thank you. I've been looking forward to doing the interview. I listened to the album last week, sent it to the PR company, and you know, I'm kind of late coming to the party for Scarlett Riot, to be honest. It's something that hasn't been on my radar, but I must say that Invicta is a stonker of an album.
Thank you so much. Thank you. It's definitely been a long time coming. It's been a good couple of years that we've been working on it, so it feels great to finally have it out there.
Yeah, you know, yeah, you're right. It's been a couple of years since you've had anything out. But I did the single Gravity a couple of months back. And you know that way when you hear a track, you just think, wow, it's, you know, just one of those ones that just from the outset just takes your breath away. And that's what happened with Gravity. And I don't know if it's because it's, you know, I'm hearing you guys literally for the first time, or it's just because you're taken by the music. I think that's kind of where I was coming from. You know, I listen to, God knows, 40, 50, 60 pieces of music every week. And, you know, sometimes you think, oh, I can, you know, take that or leave it. But I guess just the vocals and the lyrics that came from yourself just blew me away. So I must congratulate you on the album, because it's got some stonking songs on it.
Thank you so much.
So what's the I know that it's been out. What's the feedback? Seems to a lot of people seem to be liking it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I haven't seen any bad feedback, which is amazing. Like, all the reviews have been fantastic, and it's everything we hoped and more, really, because we were quite nervous about having the heavier sound and how that would go down with our hardcore older fans, because yeah, they're quite used to, you know, the pop and rock sound that we had before. Yeah. But they seem to have adjusted to it. I mean, you can't please everyone. There is some people who don't really like the new screaming elements, but with every person who dislikes it, you're gaining new fans as well. There's quite, like yeah, yourself, there's a lot of new people who haven't heard of us until this album, and they've picked it up. And so it's super exciting, because we like to make every release different from the one before, and really push ourselves to make it better than the previous release.
Absolutely. So I think when you get some of the growl elements of the vocal coming in as well, I think that adds another dimension to the album and to the band. You know, as you say, a lot of the fans were kind of used to the kind of rockier, poppier stuff, and now you've come in with a real heavier sound, and I think that you'll gain a lot of new fans with it, because I think it's got a real raw edge to it that I think that, you know, that your fans, old and new, maybe haven't heard before. And it's got a nice, crisp sound to it, you know, and you kind of think, wow, you know, I can dig this, you know. And as I say, what I tend to do with myself is I've listened to the album through first, and then I'll grab myself a glass and I'll start to review it as I'm drinking my wine, you know. I get relaxed, I think, yeah, and I go back, oh, I'm really liking this song, you know, and I play a song a couple of times, you know, and I kind of think, yeah, and it's good that, you know, that I'm hearing new stuff for the first time, you know, and I'm not afraid to admit it. I sit with bands and go, never heard the stuff, and, you know, but I'm not going to lie and go, yeah, I've listened to all your stuff, Scarlett, and it's great, because I'd be lying. You know, I think when you hear something new for the first time, it's a nice surprise as well.
Yeah, definitely. Well, thank you very much for giving us the time as well and checking us out. We appreciate the support.
Listen, it's not a problem. I think, you know, at Jace Media, you know, we get lots of stuff through, and, you know, Mix sends quite a lot of stuff, and, you know what I mean, and unfortunately, as a reviewer, you know, you can't give everyone the time. You know, you know, as I say, I'd probably do 50 pieces of music every week, you know, and that's, yeah, and that's 7 days a week, you know, and you're like, and you listen to stuff. But we, you know, we like to champion bands. We like to, you get them out there. You know, we have 100 to 120,000 viewers to the site every month. You know, this interview will go across to America, to New York, it'll go to Australia. We have an outlet in Australia, and it'll go all over Europe, you know, so you will gain some new fans, hopefully, with the release of the video. You know, I tend not to have, well, let's stick to a script that I kind of go off piece and we were talking about stuff and I'll maybe go back to stuff, because I think that makes it more interesting, you know, and I think it captivates the audience, because I'll go, what's this mad Scottish guy talking about, you know, and I'll go back, remember they were talking about this, and go, oh yeah, I'll get it now, you know. So that's kind of what I do. I don't go, I've got 10 points, I need to get them out first and hope she understands and hope she likes it, and then we'll do what we do. I just kind of go with the flow, because I think it's better that way. It kind of gives you a wee bit more creativity to talk about the album, lockdown, you know, kind of what you're doing, what you want to do, rather than me go 10 points and I'm out, and I'll go, right, you talk. You know, it's not kind of do it. So please bear with me if I'm kind of shooting all over the place, but I kind of guess that's kind of how I do my reviews. But I think that this is you'll be definitely one to watch in 2021. I think a lot of people will really
thank you very much. We appreciate that. Well, fingers crossed when everything, like, we can't wait to actually gig it again.
Yeah, I mean, what's your thoughts on that? What's your feeling with the band about getting out there and doing it? Are you looking to do anything? Are you just waiting to the until you get it all clear? Because I know that you know there's lots of festivals being cancelled all over the place. And I guess, like, for a Scotsman, for a Glaswegian, we think that when music turns the corner, especially in Glasgow, there'll be probably a gig every night for probably 6 to 9 months, because everybody will just be itching to get out there. You know, the other side of that is the European market, I think, will be, you know, it'll be a while before we get bands coming across with the Brexit side of things and everything and the touring stuff. So I guess we're planting our hopes on the British contingent, kicking it out the gate, you know, and coming at us full steam ahead.
That's it, yeah. For us, we are penciling a couple of bits in. It's difficult, like you say, to gauge when things, things are opening, but there's just going to be a massive overload of bands wanting the same dates, and everyone wanting the same sort of fans in certain bands to come and see you. But I feel, because we've released the album now, I think if we had nothing for the rest of the year, it wouldn't do the album any good. So we're looking at penciling just something in the UK, just something small, something little. And we're working on arrangements and logistics now, just something to just get us out there just a little bit before the end of the year, and then look at building ourselves back into Europe next year, because I suppose there's Brexit to think about as well. Like, we're not clear on the touring rules or arrangements or anything yet, so.
Yeah, that, I mean, I think that's going to be really hard, you know, and I think it's going to hit bands on both sides of the water, where, you know, you kind of, you want to get out there, but you've got to look at the cost implication, you've got to look at countries you can go to, you've got to look at, you know, arrangements for your crew and stuff like this. And I think it's just going to be really hard. But I think you're right, get the album out, because I think what will gather momentum is the album will come out. If you said, you know, we're going to tour in July or August, and people go, well, we haven't heard anything from you. But I think that at least the album out, people will get excited when they hear, you know, announcement coming tomorrow. People go, wow, what's happening? You know, and you're saying we've got 2 or 3 dates or 4 dates or 5 dates, and people get really excited, because I get, you know, you get the live stream, but I guess there's nothing better than going into a sweaty hall, you know, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 fans, you know, just shouting your name and just wanting you to deliver the best 90 minutes that you can on that specific night, you know. And I guess with new music, that gives you a revived energy to get out there and do it better, you know.
That's it. It'll just be exciting to be able to play the new songs. And like you say, it's more exciting because you've got something new to play and something new to show off, and just see how the reaction is, and hear everybody singing the words back to you for the first time on your new music as well. That's one of my favorite experiences.
Yeah, absolutely, because I think that's one of the main things, that when you have new music that people can resonate to it. They've listened to the album before, they've came to see you, and I think hearing it live for the first time will you know, it'll either blow people away or it'll put people off and go, not really feeling it. But I guess your hardcore fans are just happy for new music, you know, because these strange times have been, I think for a reviewing point of view, you know, new music is coming out every day. You know, where bands like yourself who have maybe sat for 3, 4, 5, 6 months and they've penciled in a couple of songs. And a lot of people have said, we had an album, we completed it in 2019, and we've now got another album on the way, and we haven't even toured the first one yet. So there is bits of that where you've got people going, yeah, we're busy right away. But I guess just the anticipation of the first date in the diary and going out there and just smashing it is, I think, nerves for you guys as well, because it's been a long time since you've played.
Yeah, definitely. We kind of made a joke to each other that our first gig on the stage will be like the first time we've ever played together as a band. We're just like not knowing what we're doing on stage.
Put on the knobs and go, is this the right one? And you know, and I think that's probably a good thing though, because it shows that you have nerves and you're a normal person. You don't go on and go like your Maidens of this world or your Bruce Springsteens, when you walk up and you rock and plug your guitar and people go, everything's perfect. I guess having a few technical hitches just makes you human, you know, and the guys will go, oh, tomorrow night will be better, but we'll turn the amp, we'll get this, we'll do the fade, because I think that's what people expect. You know, they want you to come and, I don't think, be perfect, because I think that kind of quashes the image that when you go on stage, people are going, yeah, they'll just be flawless. And I guess it's nice if you have a couple of mishaps, because it just makes you feel that you're back where you belong and you can only get better.
Yeah, exactly. And I think as well, it's all about, you know, the experiences and memories. And some fans know our songs that well that they'll know if there's a missed note on the guitar or I miss a lyric, and they'll kind of grin with us. Do you know what I mean? It just adds to that kind of show as well. And like you say, it's live and no one... nobody wants something completely perfect. Like, that's what you've got your CD for. You know, live is live, and there's nothing that beats that.
People go, yeah, if I wanted live, I could just listen to the CD. But I guess that there's nothing better than rushing into a hall, and you get the support act, and you know that you're going to be in for a stomping show, and then it happens, and you think, wow, I'm glad I waited 15 months, 18 months, because what a show they put on, you know. And I guess for you guys as well, knowing that you go out there and that you're, you know, you still have what your fans want, you know, new music or not, you know.
Yeah, definitely.
I think it's just a prerequisite to knowing that you can still write good tunes, and you still have the capacity to get the fans, whether it be bums on seats, whether it be legs in halls, just to come and listen to you thrashing out, you know, your new material, you know. And as I say, I checked the album out, and I've got 5 standouts, and you can tell me which ones you wrote, you can tell me which ones are good, you can tell me which ones I'm talking rubbish. So I've got Gravity, which, you know, is a just a belting track. I've got Underwater, which was another favourite. Stronger.
Yeah.
Into Pieces, which is my favorite on the album.
That's been quite a popular opinion actually from people who've got the album. I think because we don't really do slow songs. All our back catalogue, we've maybe only done one or two. So we made sure for this one that we could bring one out, and it took so long to write because we're not just not used to doing really, really slow songs. And we're like, we need one, let's do one. And but it was worth it. It was definitely worth spending the time writing.
It's an absolute stonker of a track. And I guess, you know, maybe it's their prerequisite. I think people now expect to have a ballad on a track, you know, or a rock ballad or a growler ballad, if you like, because, you know, you can rattle out 10, 12 heavy metal tracks and people go, but I'd like to hear Scarlett doing something a little bit different. And I guess with that, Into Pieces is just the perfect track. It just showcases, I think, all the musicians, but especially your vocal. Your vocals are just incredible.
Thank you so much. Yeah, it's definitely going to be a good one to pop in a headline set. I can see it. All the light is in the air. And
people with the phones giving it, yeah, come on, give us some more. And I think that that's good because I think I think, you know, it showcases what you guys are capable of. And as you said, it took you a little bit longer to write it. But I guess it's trying to get your creative juices flowing as to how can we put a ballad into this 10-tracker solid rock song, and how do we do it? And I guess it's taken that bit of time to, as you say, to get the arrangement right, to get the lyrics right, and then unleash it on the album. And it's an absolute killer track. So as I say, I congratulate you again, because it's nice that you can put a rock ballad in there.
Thank you.
Yeah, no, my pleasure. So obviously I kind of caught like a minute with Dan yesterday. I did the single review, I did the album review, and then he said, "Oh, feeling the love for the album," and I said, "Oh, it's a cracker. I think I'm catching up with you guys tomorrow." And then about 5 minutes later, he went, "Oh, I think it's just glow." I went, "That's cool. You know, it's all good. You know, just to let him know that you know that Jace Media herself are out there, like, you know, just championing you guys and trying to, you know, to show the love. You know, as I say, I think it's been, I think at the moment, I think it's had 1,000 views.
Wow. The album,
you know, so 1,900, some of that. My boss keeps me up to date every day with all the stuff that I do and I put out, and they'll say, "Oh, this is doing really well." And I guess, you know, it just shows you the popularity that you have. You know?
Thank you. We appreciate that. I think as well, like, you don't realize, I think, because you get so busy with the promotion and things, you don't realize what views you're getting and response you're getting. And for us as well, because we're with Despots Records, we don't find out for a while, like, how things are sold and numbers and things like that. So you kind of feel a bit oblivious to all that sort of stuff to start with. So it's nice to kind of hear it in context.
I kind of think for us, you know, I really enjoy this part of the job where you interview, you know, rock stars, because, you know, that's what you are. You're rock stars, you know, you're rock stars who are creating really good music. And I really enjoy the interaction because you get to know the person, you get to know the band, you get to know what makes them tick. And I think when you put it out, people go, "Yeah, I really like that girl. She's just like dead normal," you know, and you're like, "Yeah, but you're just a normal person who has a really good talent, that you write good music and you've got a blistering set of pipes on you."
Thank you. You know, that's what we wrote our song Human about as well, off the album. So just that, you know, no matter what path anyone takes in life, everyone's still human at the end of the day. And
It's been an extraordinary 15 months. You know, it's just been really, I think it's been really hard. How did you guys find it in lockdown? Did you get together much, or was it just Zooming, or did you try and stay positive writing while we're going through all this?
It was definitely difficult. We started recording the album March 2020. And literally it was that day that Boris come on the TV and we were sent out the studio and we didn't get back to record till August. But I was saying to the guys, I think that we've been lucky in the respect that we've had the album to concentrate on. So while, you know, we've been concentrating on making sure we're happy with the songs, the production, so all the production layers of piano and synths and strings that you can hear, We've been putting all those elements together whilst waiting to go back into the studio, and then sorting out the promotion, the press and the artwork and what singles we're going to have and the videos. So luckily we've had all that to concentrate on, whereas a lot of bands literally have nothing, just waiting for all to open. So we've been lucky in one respect.
I kind of guess that like I said earlier on, I think that's what starts to make it real when you look at the PR, you know, the artwork, you know, the selection of songs and what order they're going in and who's going to go on and do the interviews, who's going to, you know, plug it, you know, if you do radio stuff. And I guess that makes it exciting because you know that it's coming to release day and you're just waiting for the phone to ring for people to say, let's chat. You know, when I got the album from Mick, I said to him, well, what about an interview with Scarlett? He went, funnily enough, Danny, you're next on my list. I'm like, yeah. Heard that old chestnut. And he went, no. He said, I wanted to see if you could do it. Last week I was on holiday. It was my birthday last week. And he said, hope you have a nice birthday. We'll try and slot something in for next week because she's really busy. You know, and as I say, for me, it's appreciation as well that you're finding the time to chat to us. You know, we will only do our best to get you out there. You know, people look at this ugly face and go, my God, he's talking to, who's he talking to now? You know, and we put it out there and people go, yeah, I really enjoyed that. You know, he talked like no one's business. But I think it's just getting in depth into Scarlett Riot and what they're all about. And I think that's important. And I guess for you guys, it's just, you know, wanting to get your faces out there so that people, you know, remember you. But I think it's one of those things that, you know, once you hear the first chords or you hear the first lyrics, you know that you're going to get an excellent album and it's been worth the wait.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I mean, for us, just exposure in general, you know, been able to put our music out there to more people and have as much press as we possibly can. So we've kind of cram-packed it all into the last 3 weeks. And so I've got in from work and then I've sat and done interviews from like 6 till 11 every night for the past 3 weeks. But I've just started to get used to it. It's like, it feels like the normal now.
I think that's nice though, Scarlett, that you have people wanting to chat to you. You have people wanting to know what you're all about, you know, what the guys are about. And yes, it's exhausting because I'm like you. I work, you know, I'm out the door at 6:30 every day and I'm home at 6:30 at night. And then I'm going, I need to open the laptop, I need to do some reviewing, or I've got to talk to someone. But I think it gives you another buzz. You put the Zoom on and you go, you're sitting patiently waiting for the light to come on and you go, right, okay, I'm up. And then and you do your thing and you think, wow, I feel really invigorated. And I think that's, you know, for you guys as well. Possibly that you're talking the same interview, you know, 5-6 times a night for the last 3 weeks. You're thinking, guys, I need a break. But I guess it's just good that people still want to reach out and chat. You know?
There's been so many nice people as well. So many people who, like, all the interviews, people have known the background of the band, have known, you know, they weren't just interviewing us. You know how some people don't know anything about you, whereas every single person who's interviewed us has been super into us and absolutely, you know, not a bad word to say. And it's flattering, it's lovely. And, you know, we have the time of day for everybody who's, you know, pays an interest in the band.
Yeah, absolutely. So when are we expecting you to hit Glasgow? That's if you're going to start your world tour, you need to come to Glasgow. Don't bother with anywhere else. Just say, I'm starting the world tour in Glasgow, and that's it.
I know, that's it. We haven't been to Glasgow in a while either. I think last time was Edinburgh, so
Glasgow. You go to Bannerman's, I take it?
Yes, we did, yeah.
Yeah, Bannerman's. Yeah. You have to come to Glasgow. Glasgow would really embrace you. You know, Glaswegians love their live music. They love getting out for a few pints and just watching, whether it's new bands, whether it's bands that have been about for years. They just love their music. They love the authenticity of just going and seeing a new band for the first time and coming away and going, they were brilliant. You know, they were, you know, or they were not very good, but next time it'll be better, you know, and stuff like that. So I hope that you do get to Glasgow soon and blast out the new album.
That would be really cool. Yeah, we hope so. We hope that's so. Cool. I think last that's time cool. we come over was audio. And I think we headlined there, and that was a few years ago now.
Yeah, but you know, there are so many cool little places in Glasgow for you to come, but you know, I guess it's just getting out there, getting the feelers out for the first couple of shows, and then building on that. You want everyone to stay safe. You want everyone to be, you know, aware of, you know, what it's all about coming to a show. So I do hope that, you know, you will get to Glasgow, or if not Scotland, because obviously I can't be biased. Gal, you need to come to Glasgow. So if you have to go to Edinburgh, I'll need to come through Edinburgh, but there you go. But I hope you get here soon. I don't want to hold up too much of your time. It's been an absolute pleasure chatting to you. I think you've probably had my review, I take it, or not.
Sorry?
Have you had my review? Have you read my review yet?
Not yet. No. If you drop Mick the link, and then yep. I'll definitely take a look at it. Yes. Have you tagged us in it on Instagram and Twitter and things?
It goes up. What we do first, the video and everything will go on to YouTube, and then it goes on to Facebook, and then goes into Instagram, and then goes to Twitter, and then we send it out to our partners in Australia and America and stuff like that. You know, I will check with my boss where he sent the album to. I'm sure Mick may have it. But if not, I will drop it into him tomorrow, and you can critique it, and then you can get me back and say your review was rubbish or it was good. I don't believe that when you're doing a review, if you say, oh, there's 11 tracks on it and I liked 6 and I didn't like 5, because I think that's just, you know, it's demoralising for the band. What I like to do is I'll play it through and I pick out my standouts, you know, which make me want to listen to the album more, you know, and I don't believe in saying it was all right, it was a 7 out of 10, and you're going, you know, we're not preparing and we've got a 7 out of 10, you know. for me listening to you guys, it's a 9 out of 10. So
thank you, and
I really do mean that, Scarlett. It's a really, really cracking little album. I hope it does really, really well. I hope you guys have lots of success with it. And I do hope that you get back to Scotland sometime soon.
We hope so. And thank you so much for the kind words. We appreciate it.
Not a problem. As I say, I'll drop it off to Mick tomorrow, and then we'll see where we go from there. And I'll obviously just keep in touch, and you can let us know. As I say, Mick will drop his lines from time to time about what you're doing and stuff. So, but any support we can give you, it's not a problem. We'll gladly do that.
Thank you so much. It's been great to talk with you.
Absolute pleasure for myself. This is Darren from Jacepedia in conversation with vocal powerhouse Scarlett from Scarlett Riot. The video will be up tomorrow, if not Thursday. I will let you know the link, Chloe, and we'll take it from there.
That's lovely. All right, thank you.
Take care. Stay safe. Bye.